in right now. All right, where are y'all? What school do you guys go to?
Summitt Charter School.
Summitt Charter. And what are you guys doing here today?
Well, we're visiting.
You're visiting?
We just did a what?
Oh. I tried to do that. That's not real. That's not that easy.
Like it's on that table?
Huh?
Like it's on that table over there?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, that is a God's eye, isn't it?
He'll be waiting.
Okay. All right. And then y'all are going to do story time now with Miss Cat, right? Miss Cat, what's the story time on?
We're reading Rainbow Fish.
Ooh.
How many of you guys have read this book before? Only one in this book.
I have.
Shade of blue and green, and purple with sparkling silver scales among them. Do you think that's the most beautiful fish you've ever seen? The other fish were amazed at his beauty. They called him Rainbow Fish. Come on, Rainbow Fish, they would call. Come and play with us. But the Rainbow Fish would just glide past, proud and silent, letting his scales shimmer. He didn't really want to play with the other fish, huh?
Maybe he just wanted to do some stuff.
Yeah, maybe he just wanted some alone time?
Yeah.
Let's see. One day, a little blue fish followed after him. Rainbow Fish, he called. Wait for me. Please give me one of your shiny scales. They're so wonderful, and you have so many. You want me to give you one of my special scales? Who do you think you are? The Rainbow Fish cried, "Get away from me." Shocked, the little blue fish swam away. He was so upset, he told his friends, and no one would have anything to do with the Rainbow Fish. They turned away when he swam by. What good were the dazzling, shimmering scales with no one to admire them? Now he was the loneliest fish in the entire ocean. One day, he poured out his troubles to the starfish. I really am beautiful. Why doesn't anybody like me? I can't answer that for you, said the starfish. But if you go beyond the coral reef to a deep cave, you will find the wise octopus. Maybe she can. Found the cave. It was very dark inside. He couldn't see anything. Then, suddenly, two eyes caught him in their glare, and the octopus emerged from the darkness. I've been waiting for you, said the octopus with a deep voice. The waves have told me your story. This is my advice. Give a glittering scale to each of the other fish. You will no longer be the most beautiful fish in the sea, but you will discover how to be happy. I can't, the rainbow fish started to say, but the octopus had already been disappeared into a dark cloud of ink. Give away my scales? My beautiful, shining scales? Never. How could I ever be happy without them? Suddenly, he felt the light touch of a fin. The little blue fish was back. Rainbow Fish, please don't be angry. The rainbow fish wavered. Only one very small shimmery scale, he thought. Well, maybe I wouldn't miss just one. Carefully, the rainbow fish pulled out the smallest scale and gave it to the little fish. Thank you. Thank you so very much, the little blue fish bubbled as he touched the shiny scale in among the blue ones. A rather peculiar feeling came over the rainbow fish. For a long time, he watched the little blue fish run back and forth with his new scale glittering in the water. The little blue fish whizzed along the ocean with his scale flashing, so it didn't take long before and right. And the more he gave away, the more delighted he became. And when the water around him filled with glimmering scales, he at last felt at home among the other fish. Finally, the rainbow fish had the one shiny scale left. It was his most prized possession, and he had given them away. Yet, he was very happy. Come on, rainbow fish, the fish called. Come and play with us. Here I come, said rainbow fish. And as happy as a splash, he swam off to join his friends. The end.
Why did you give us?
I gave you my rainbow scales.
You got it for you.
Since we can all have rainbow scales.
What do you guys say?
Wait, what's the moral of the story?
Rainbow fish is giving those scales away.
But it means what? What was he doing?
He was being nice and helping his friend feel nice too.
And your parents and usually always tell you it's nice to what?
Be nice.
Yeah. Nice to share. That's right. So that's what the moral of the story was about.
This is one of the things that you guys made earlier.
Mm-hmm.
We can't, well, if when you go home, if you want to connect them, you can. That would be a fun thing.
Okay.